9-3, ranked number 18 in the country in the championship game for the second time in 3 years against number 7 Texas. 11-1 for the first time since 2009. That's the last time they won the Big 12 title. Hi, everybody, and welcome. Sean McDonough along with Greg McElroy. Delighted to have you with us for the start of this huge day of college football. Very big for Texas. Greg, the Longhorns trying to have one last opportunity at this conference championship in their 28th and last year in the Big 12. And beyond that, a win today, and they're still alive with their hopes for the college football playoff. If they lose, they're going to be out. A much improved this season, talented everywhere, and the quarterback has been a huge difference maker this season.
And Quinn Ewers really committed to his craft in the offseason. He lost weight. He became a better teammate. He's become a better leader, and he's much more comfortable in year two in Steve Sarkisian's offense. The completion percentage is through the roof compared to where it was a year ago. He's getting the ball out faster to an outstanding wide receiver core that's very diverse on the outside.
It has been a very interesting season in Stillwater. The Cowboys started the year 2-2, and then they made a very good decision to start handing the ball with great regularity to Ollie Gordon.
It's really remarkable that Ollie Gordon was able to lead the country in rushing and yet only had 19 carries.
So the Longhorns will kick it off to Mike Gundy's team. 9-3. Winners of 7 of their last 8. When they made the decision to lean heavily on Ollie Gordon, and they made Bowman the full-time starter at quarterback. He was part of a 3-man rotation in the first 3 games of the season. It's usually close when these two teams get together. Oklahoma State has won the last 2 in each of the last 2 regular seasons. They didn't play in this regular season. Will Stone kicks off. And Brennan Presley's going to try to return it. And went down just shy of the 25. Here's Molly McGrath.
Well, Sean, Oklahoma State last played in this game in 2021 and lost by a matter of inches on a failed fourth down dive. And veteran wide receiver and return man Brennan Presley called that loss a nightmare. Told us he still can't watch that final play to this day, calling it gut-wrenching. But Presley made sure to point to that missed opportunity to motivate his teammates to lock in, fight for every inch, because the small details could be the difference between a title or a lot of sleepless nights. And Mike Gundy admitted that loss keeps him up at night. He will never get over it, but a win today will help, guys.
And back then, they were the team hoping to get into the college football playoff with a win and came up literally inches short. Bowman on first down. Content just to fire it away as he was under immediate pressure from Baron Sorrell, part of an outstanding defensive front for Texas.
Bowman's gonna have to be great today. This Texas defense is gonna sell out against the run. They do have a couple liabilities in the back end, but Bowman has been very solid up until the last 3 weeks with his decision making. 6 interceptions in the last 3 games. He's got to be smart today.
And when you asked the coaches for Oklahoma State who has to play great in the game, they said Alan Bowman. It is Brooks had a tremendous year, played in 10 games and averaged 114 yards per game, one of the very best in the country. But since he went out, Baxter had a 100-yard-plus game at Iowa State, and last week in their win against Texas Tech, Jaden Blue ran for 100-plus.
They're definitely missing Jonathan Brooks. I mean, he's amazing, but these guys have filled in so beautifully these last couple weeks.
Like most of the top teams, they have a lot of depth and talent. C.J. Baxter, a lot of running room. He's out of bounds near the 10. It'll be another first down for Texas.
And a great block on the edge, too, by the 2 tight ends. Gunnar Helm, number 85, and number 0, J.T. Sanders. Basically capturing the outside shoulder and allowing Baxter to the edge.
Ewers throws it. Man open in the end zone. Touchdown, Texas. Adonai Mitchell.
Great misdirection here from Steve Sarkisian. Fakes the pitch. Boots Ewers out. He gives a quick pump fake to the flat. And Adonai Mitchell creating great separation in the back end against Corey Black is the Dr. Pepper pylon cam. It's a great shot there on the end of Mitchell falling in before the touchdown.
And Bert Auburn on for the extra point. Well, Mitchell has a knack for coming up big in big games. He did it at Georgia, and he's 22nd edition of the conference title game. The conference began in 1996. There was a 6-year stretch, 2011 through 16, where they didn't play a championship game. It is back, and Texas leads this one with an early touchdown. Neither one of these kickers has a big leg in terms of touchbacks. They faked a reverse on the kickoff return, and it's Presley across the 25. Here's Molly.
Well, Sean, you can tell Cowboys running back Ollie Gordon is fired up today. He came off of the sideline, pumped up their wide receivers, talked to them about their run blocking, and then went individually to each offensive lineman. And he's been a leader on the sidelines. He's from nearby Fort Worth. His mom said he has around 200 people here today. He has high school teammates, family, and friends, and you can tell he wants to show off, guys.
They did not give it to him on the opening possession. They threw three passes, all of them incomplete by Alan Bowman. So he gets the call for the first time and gets stopped after a gain of 2.
A lot of his success this year has come out of the pistol formation. That was something they really implemented and dove into after the first 3 games of the year. And he has just completely taken off. They simplified their run schemes. They only run about 4. There are variations to the run schemes, but they're a less is more type of approach, and it's been very successful this year.
Just part of a 3-man rotation with Jaden Nixon and Elijah Collins at the start of the year. He gets some running room and gets chopped down just beyond the first down marker by the freshman Malik Muhammad. A gain of 9 and the first down of the day for Oklahoma State. And Mike Gundy said they like the pistol because it allows Gordon directly behind the quarterback to see tackle to tackle. He has a great knack for the cutbacks. We saw that last week in the rousing come from behind win against BYU. He's also an excellent receiver. That's his 34th catch of the year, and he's swung down by Jalen Ford, the outstanding linebacker. Gordon going to the sideline now after he was slow to get up, and they have a big problem. We mentioned Nixon and Collins were sharing time with him early. Neither one of them are here. So the backup running back is Sesi Bailahi, who's had 4 carries all year. He's a freshman, number 20, and he has the catch, his first reception of the year. Collins has been out for a while, and it was announced just prior to the game that he wouldn't go today. So a surprise on the field. It's Bailahi. And if Gordon can't return, the chance is remarkably slim for Oklahoma State to pull off the upset today. They're already a 2-touchdown underdog. Leon Johnson, the motion man, on 3rd and 6. Quick pass.